was a first and a second. Hallelujah. So we're going to go to First Timothy. First Timothy chapter 4, and the background for our sermon is verses 1 through 10. Moments we have this morning, we just want to share with you verse 10. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 10. Reading from the New Revised Standard Bible, it says to us, "For to this end we toil and we struggle, because we have our hope set on the living God, amen, who is the Savior of all people, especially of those who believe in Him."
Amen.
For to this end, we toil and we struggle, because we have our hope is set on a living God. Amen.
Amen.
Who is the Savior of all people, especially those that believe in Him.
Amen.
And we simply want to encourage you this morning, speaking from the sermon title, "For Christ's Sake."
Amen.
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 As we talked about in Bible study on Thursday night, because we are part of the kingdom of God, as saints of God, you need to stop trying to put so much stuff on you.
Amen.
That's too much weight for you to have, no land. And so we learned in Bible study Thursday that not only has the kingdom of God come to this earth, but the kingdom of God lives in us, found in Luke's gospel, that talks about how the kingdom of God is in us. And so we, the body of Christ, we must be encouraged. And see, this verse here, verse 10, talks about, yes, you will toil, yes, you will struggle, yes, you will have trouble, yes, you're going to go through stuff. But you don't have to worry, because your hope is in a living God.
Amen.
So point number one takes us to that. We, the body of Christ, we are encouraged, first of all, to walk in God's wisdom.
Amen.
See, what happens, a lot of the circumstances we find ourselves in, a lot of it is because we made bad choices.
Amen.
Now, saints of God, it doesn't matter how saved you are, that even if you're saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, and you've made some bad choices, you're going to have to deal with those consequences.
Amen.
But I praise good God, because, see, with grace and mercy, even though you have to give an account of it, amen, the Lord still takes us through it, amen.
Amen.
So I'm glad that even unto this end, even for His sake, that we have to go through toils and struggles and problems, because our hope is in a living God.
Amen.
Saints of God, the body of Christ, the kingdom of God, we are encouraged to walk not in our own wisdom, but in His wisdom.
Amen.
It's something about the wisdom of God that will allow us, amen, to go through situations, and it's not that you know so much, it's not that you know it all, but when you pray and commit it unto God, God will lead you in such a way that, yes, on the other side of the toil and on the other side of the struggle, you will come out, as the songwriter said, as fear goes. Secondly, as I look at the text, and it came out in our church school this morning, amen, thank you, Brother Joe, as we talked about, first, encourage for His sake, we are encouraged to walk in His wisdom. Secondly, for His sake, we are encouraged to walk in love.
Amen.
Turn to your neighbor, say neighbor.
Amen.
Walk in love.
Walk in love.
Amen. In church school this morning, we talked about it.
Amen.
Last Sunday, we talked about it.
Amen.
The humility and love, and it came up this week.
Amen.
And I think what happens for me, and we missed an opportunity on yesterday because I didn't know we were going to have so many people at the bowling alley and so many people and Elizabeth thinking, we missed an opportunity. Reverend Carnetta said, you know, Sister Kim was the only one with her t-shirt on. That was a prime opportunity to be a witness.
Amen.
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 You know, I know somebody was watching, and we didn't know this, but when we went to Liz's Thicket last night, right, you know, I approached the manager, and Mr. Williams is one of the, their parents started Liz's Thicket in Columbia. So he knows me like that. Amen. But I never presented myself as a preacher to him. But the waitress told him the speech I gave. I ain't even old for her to overhear my speech. But y'all know when Jesus was ministering, folk were overhearing him too.
Amen.
And those of you that were there last night, I told them, you know, I took a moment before we ate and just told them. I just enjoy being with the people. Amen.
Amen.
We had a good time at the bowling alley. Had a good time last evening, so I shared with them. And so the waitress went and told Mr. Williams that. So when I went up to make ready on the bill and squared it up, and I took care of it like we're supposed to, amen. Some people say, well, you love the Lord so, and then you go eat at a restaurant and don't even give a tip.
Amen.
What kind of God you serve?
Amen.
The Lord allowed you to go to that restaurant so that you could be a blessing to that waitress. Because she's not making a whole lot of money.
Amen.
Those of you that have been a waiter or waitress, y'all know what I'm talking about. Amen.
Amen.
So the Lord allowed us an opportunity, and little Jakari and Makai, they keep seeing. They said, you keep saying that stuff about how favor follows you and how people are blessed. You know, we look at places, don't we? It's not many people there, we'll get there, but we get there and be flowing. But Mr. Williams told me something. And I said, I want to square up the bill and we're going to be good to Miss Kimmy. Kimmy was our waitress last night. So I told him to go ahead and take care of it. I'm going to go on back here. And I said, don't tell him, amen. I told him, don't tell the people, like Jesus did.
Amen.
Don't tell.
Amen.
But some of them noticed how Miss Kimmy was just being so sweet to me last night. So, you know, you don't forget who, you know, take care. You know. So, I couldn't run out of tea last night. She kept shooting. So, Mr. Williams said to me, he said, Reverend, and that's the first time he said Reverend. But it was because of what Kim had told him that the pastor gave a speech and told him how much he just appreciated his people. And Mr. Williams came to me and said, you must have known we've had an off day today.
Mm-hmm.
I said, no, I didn't know you had had an off day. I said, I live around the corner, and we had gone bowling, and my folks said they wanted some good food, and I knew we could come over here and you know, not get yams, but, you know, everything else is good, amen. Somebody got a double dose of macaroni and cheese. I ain't calling no name, but anyway. But it was just a blessing, but I told him I didn't know all this. But do you not know Miss Kimmy? She said, oh, God is good up in this place. She said, y'all might be cold, but she said, I'm hot, I'm running. She was running, amen. And so we bless God that he allowed us an opportunity to be a blessing.
Amen.
So that they wouldn't leave there and say, oh, them church people did what church people did, and that's be stingy,
amen.
My God too good for me to be stingy. I ain't gonna lie to him. Because he blesses me even when I ain't looking for it. So I tell him, thank you for the opportunity to be a blessing. But we are talking now about how we, the body of Christ, have been called to walk in love. We've been called to be ambassadors to show love on every side.
Amen.
Even when family and friends and co-workers don't show love, we are required to show love anyhow.
Amen.
It may mean biting your tongue and not saying something. Amen.
Amen.
I think everybody up in here got another side. And if you keep pushing the right buttons.
Amen.
I ain't talking about how long you've been in the church. I'm just saying what I'm saying. Amen.
Amen.
But even, Brother Greg, even when that happens, at the end of the day, you've got to have a testimony that you belong to the Lord.
Yeah.
Because see, no doubt, they've been hearing you talk about you sing on the choir.
Mm-hmm.
You go to church.
Mm-hmm.
You been reading your Bible.
Mm-hmm.
And then you up there cussing.
Mm-hmm.
And fussing. And you're to move papers and stuff out of the way because you take it off earrings and you back it up. At the end of the day, they gonna say, I thought they were saved. I thought they were in church. I thought. So at the end of the day, your testimony, and I know people gonna push you, amen.
Amen.
Until you get victory in that area, the enemy's gonna continue to try and test you. But I've come to let you know, hold on until you get victory in that area, amen. Hallelujah, because we've been called as the body of Christ to walk in love.
Amen.
Well, let me hasten on to an end that we got to wrap this sermon up because for his sake, we've been encouraged to walk in his wisdom. For his sake, we've been encouraged to walk in love. And finally, thirdly, our last point is that for his sake, we have been encouraged to walk as children of light.
Amen.
Do you not know you are where you are because the Lord needs some light? Amen.
Amen.
You live where you live. Your house is where it is. And you rent from where you rent because the Lord needs some light in that dark place.
Amen.
The place where you are employed and the place where you work, the Lord has called you to be a light in dark places.
Amen.
Do you not know that wherever your family is in this community, wherever you are, God has called you to be a light in this dark place?
Yeah.
Well, I need to let you know that this area, this community is where the Lord has called me. So I need to know that the Lord wants me to be a light in this community. And y'all, I'ma let it shine. Because when I was reading verse 10, it says that our hope is in a living God. I don't know anybody. Well, you know, there's some dead gods around here. Small g. There's some stuff that's dead, but my God that I serve, he's alive. The songwriter said he's alive, and then they come back and say, yes, how do you know he's alive? I can feel him in my hands. I can feel him in my feet. And every now and then, I feel him all over me. He holds me. He comforts me. He keeps me even when I need to be kept. So, yes, I'm encouraged to be the light of Christ. I'm to show people God. Word, and the more I keep meditating on his word both day and night, I'm gonna keep being a living testimony and a living epistle to somebody. They may not come to church, but they may be reading your life, they may be watching you. So, watch how you treat people, watch how you walk, watch how you handle people. Jesus.
Yes.
We want to walk in His wisdom. We want to walk in love. We want to be children of light.
Yep. Yep.
Not darkness, but of light.
Yeah.
I know we're going to struggle. I know we're going to talk. But Pastor Donnie McClurkin said, you get up again.
Amen.
And saints, you're going to get up again.
Oh, yes.
Get knocked down, you're going to get up again.
Yeah.
That's the wonderful thing about God. He loves us. He cares for us. And His desire is for other people to know that the same God that saved you and delivered you, He will do it for others.
Amen.
He has no respect of person. Hallelujah. Let us pray. God, we thank you that the joy of the Lord is our strength.
Yeah.
And we've come into this place to be encouraged of you, God. You've been so good to us, so kind. You've called us as a congregation and a faith community to be encouraged, to walk in your wisdom, to walk in your love, and to be your witness, to be the light of Christ.
Yeah.
God, we say thank you.
Thank you.
God, we love you in this place.
Yes.
Our delight is to please you in all that we do.
Yeah.
God, we give your name praise.
Yeah. Lord Jesus.
It's in Jesus. Jesus Christ's name we pray.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.